Hello everyone, I'm Tina Adams Stuffel. I am the owner and artist at tinasfinearts.com. Today I am going to show you how to assemble stretcher bars and stretch your own canvas. So let's get started. The stretcher bars I use are the Righteosyn Best, I think they're called Best Righteosyn Heavy Duty Stretcher Bars because they're just very high quality kiln drying, and that's what I choose to work with. They are cut into a tongue and groove to where they fit together here, okay? And it's real important, you know, to stick with the same brand, because if you try to put two different brands together, it likely or may not work. All right. These have always been good for me. And how they work, it's a tongue and groove thing here. So it just slides in, see, like so. And then you got to wiggle it, put some muscle into it. All right. And I've done two sides for you. So you continue on with your all four sides until you get what you have or what you're looking for, which will look like this, 24 by 30. Now, lesson learned early on for me, okay? You can't just put it together. You have to make sure it's square, because if your artwork ends up in a frame somewhere, you will have issues if it's not squared, obviously. So always use, one of these squares to make sure I have things on right. And I just kind of look around the sides and make sure if there's anything showing off to the side after I've evenly lined it with the top or the bottom, that lets me know. Sometimes I have to give it a push like that way or that way to straighten it. So I check all four edges that way. And another way, once you're done with that, you can also check with your tape measure, and you should always double check. So let's see if we can tilt this over here to where you can take a look and find out how this, excuse me, how this works here. All right, so we're not measuring that way. What you want to measure is, let's go over here. All right, corner, and make sure you get in the same spot. I try to get right in the very corner. It's a corner. This is a 24 by 30 canvas stretcher bars will accommodate a canvas of that size. And this is like a 38 1/4 from corner to corner. And the opposite corner should be the exact same, which it is, 38 1/4. So now that we know we have that, I've already done this yesterday, so I didn't take your time. Now that we have that straight, we're going to proceed with cutting our canvas. Okay, so now we're ready to go ahead and stretch our canvas onto the stretcher bars. So let's hop to it. First off, primed side, unprimed side. I always buy mine primed because it's much simpler. So when you're ready to stretch, make sure that prime surface, and make sure your surface is, you know, clean, free of debris. Center your stretcher bars on here and just run it through a quick check before you do it to make sure that the sides give you enough room to staple. So I should wrap around on these bars. I like to have them wrap around about an inch on either side in the back. This is a couple inches wide. All right, so then we're going to go ahead. This and what happened, I did cut that one a little long, so I did, before we came back here, I trimmed this off. So that's another reason to double check, because if it's too long, it'll get a little bulky and in your way. All right. So first things first, I use a Bostitch stapler or staple gun. And I do use the stainless steel staples, which are, this is what I like to use. And I'm going to tell you why I bought, let's see, was it 1/4, 1/2 inch, 3/4? I'm trying to remember. Probably not 3/4 because it's a little thick for the, when I first started doing this, and I had fits. 5/16 is the key. I don't know why. I think it has something to do because the wood is extra hard. It's an extra sturdy, heavy duty bar. 5/16 is what I use. You don't have to use stainless, but if you want your clients to be a little extra happy with their work, I would highly recommend it. Now, a lot of people will tell you, you put one staple in here, you pull stretch, a staple over here, and so forth. Based on my experience, sometimes that one staple pulls, okay? So it'll pull out when you put the tension on the other side. So I'm going to go ahead and go with two right now. You know, hold it down like that, give it one shot. And I put them about inch, roughly about an inch, inch and a half apart, okay? Now I have something to really work with because that's a secure starting spot. So what you want to do, flip it around. And see, that was a little, it was a little crooked here. So you want to make sure you're straight again. And then this is where you start using, these are called canvas pliers, okay? You can do it with your hand, but it really does help. And I just pull. Pull pretty tight. You can see almost like a little, you can see a wrinkle here, okay? But that's okay, it will come out. So I'm gonna do another right across from where we were. Another there. And by the way, it's a good idea to have one of these little flat screwdrivers because if a staple does go in funky or give you some trouble, I find this is the easiest way. These little teeny tiny flathead screwdrivers. Okay, it's not any bigger than my hand. All right, so we're going to go down here and finish this up. Stretch because I gotta, yeah, pull that bubble out there. Because right. I had a, it wasn't a bubble, but it was a wave in the canvas where the tension needs to be adjusted. All right, one there. Flip your canvas around. Like to double check before I get going here too much. Pull them tight because if you're shipping into various climates, let's see. It will affect how your canvas works. I just had to restretch a lot of mine that went to Florida because the humidity caused it to sag. All right, here we go. Pulled every time until probably, well, even towards the end. Should keep your tension going. Do about two on each side each time. Some people just do one, but that's a lot of flipping for me, and I find a couple on either side until I'm finished. About an inch, inch and a half, it works. Okay, now the corners are one of the trickier parts. So let's go ahead and talk about the corners. What I have done is I've stapled an inch or two away from the corner, all right? And the reason is because you're gonna have to have some room to work with what we're gonna do on folding these corners. So let me adjust this so you can see. There it is, all right. This corner here is where we're gonna start, all right? Now it's a little tricky. You're gonna pull till this is flat here. Hold it with your thumb. You're really just gonna make a crease right around that corner. And as you do, the inside of this is gonna fold over like so, all right? Make sure that it creases all the way down to the bottom. And then if you need to tuck this in to make it look nice or keep it from hanging over the edges, you can tuck this little part right here inside, okay? So then you got that. Take your canvas pliers. I'm trying to pull this towards me so you can see. Go ahead and give it a good top pull there. You can hold these together as they're folded. Good top pull underneath. go ahead, because it's underneath, staple that part tight. Okay, I'm still about an inch away from the side, the corner where the corners meet. Okay, here we are. All right, now we want to pull this taut as well. All right. Sometimes I just give that corner, I usually give it two staples because it's thick. And this, by the way, is a number 12 heavyweight canvas. So it's thicker to work with than the other ones. The ones you buy in the store are probably 8 to 10 ounce weight or lighter weight, thinner canvas. All right, so we got that side. So we're gonna go do the same here on this side. Can keep repeating so you can see this. Let's just make a good pull here and give this one more staple right now. If you staple too close into your corners, it gets a little hard to work with. So that's why I like to leave a little extra room until I actually get in there and do it. Alright. And I want to make sure that's folded in enough that this doesn't hang over the side as well. Just do this where I can get some tension from where I'm standing. Just these canvas pliers again and just pull that baby tight in the corner. There we are. All right, two corners ago and we'll have a canvas. All righty. Let's see what we got here. Excuse my sniffles. I suffer with allergies, so sniffling mess here. Let's see here. Let's do this. Let's see. Too funny. I needed two staples. Let's try this. There she is, we have it. 24 by 30, nice. No wrinkles, no nothing. Wrapped around the sides. All right. I hope that helps you. I'll write a little bit more about this on my blog. And I also had a little experience with the canvas the other day that was wrinkled from how it was stored. And I ran into some problems with it, so I want to talk to you about that, and I'll tell you about it on my blog. So check it out at tinasfineArts.com. There's a news tab, and you can pull the drop down menu underneath and read my blog post there, or you can subscribe to my newsletter or both. Thanks for watching. If you like this, please share, and I hope that you have a wonderful day.